Hi, if you've been wondering what the PDF Butler team was up to the past months, well, we've been serving a lot of customers, making every implementation a success, and we have been working very hard on our spring release. I'm always surprised on how many features the team is able to finish in such a short period, because we have multiple releases per year, and the period between the releases is very short. So without further ado, let me introduce you to Spring Release and go through all the new features. We have a new batch package, so it means it's an extra package, an extra application next to PDF Butler Core. This allows you to schedule your batches, for instance, creation of invoices, contract renewals, things like that. So you can just create them 1,000 every day, 10,000 at the end of the month with the batch package. It's all possible. We have improved support for Process Builder and Visual Flow. We were always able to be called via Process Builder and Visual Flow, but you had to write some Apex yourself. Now we have our own Apex invocable, and just by a couple of configuration steps, you can insert these into your Process Builders and Visual Flows. We have a very good, very strong Lightning component, but we get a lot of questions of people just wanting a quick action button on top of their Lightning page. So we have created a Visual Forge page that actually does all the same steps as our Lightning components, and you can use that as a button on top of your Classic or even your Lightning pages. So same experience for everybody, Classic or Lightning. We, of course, learned a lot from our customers, and we see that they request extra delivery options, means that you can store your documents as attachments or files, or you cannot store them and do your own actions with it or just download them. But we also got a lot of questions to say, if we create them again, can it not just be overwritten? So if you store them as an attachment or a file, you can just overwrite them. Or even with files, you can add new versions. So it means that you can keep a real history of all the documents that were created in a specific context. Since fall of last year, we were able to interact without coding with DocuSign and Adobe Sign. But these kind of tools, they have a lot of features and are also constantly improving. So we have redesigned our setup and we have improved a lot. So you can use all of the features and configurations of DocuSign and Adobe Sign directly out of the box with PDF Butler. Next to that, we see that it's not always necessary to have a real digital signature via Adobe Sign or DocuSign, but sometimes it's just easy to have a sign pad, means that you can just sign on your page via your mouse or via your finger on the tablet, and the picture of your signature will immediately be inserted into the document. Then a next big thing that we were working on, Excel. We learned from our customers how they want to work with Excel when downloading data from Salesforce. They actually want to create real reports and dashboards from Excel. So it's cool to have a dump of data, but then that your dashboard is immediately updated, means all your calculations, all your averages, all your charts, and everything is immediately updated. When you have a big overview, you want to immediately see in one view what is the problem, what is the focus areas. So we have some conditional formatting. Same thing for pivot tables. So you download the data from Salesforce. You want your pivot table to be updated in your Excel. I always already mentioned the dynamic charts. So means you have a chart, a pie chart, or any type of chart. You get new data from Salesforce. You probably want to update that from the minute you open your Excel. And then an improvement on the repeating sheets. So now you can have real sheets that you can repeat and have sections within those sheets that you can repeat. The same kind of functionality you have in MS Word and PDF documents. So really complex stuff. Yeah, we can handle it. Complex document templating, also something we have learned from our customers. We have seen that the usage of the template goes really well. A lot of customers, they use it for their reusable stuff like terms and conditions, document or product information, things like that. But they also want to go further in the usage of words, line, and add multi columns and sections and page breaks and have pages in landscape and through each other. So all of this stuff is now supported. You can just insert these kind of complex templates directly into your main document, and all the headers and footers and page numbers, they will just keep running just as you're used to with using templates. And then out of the box, we came with a test environment and a production environment. So it means that sometimes you were testing and making changes in the same time. This, of course, is not ideal for the development process. That's why we decided to just give you an extra free stage called dev. So you have a dev environment now, a test environment, and a production environment. If you need more environments and you want to map it to your environments of your systems, like staging, demo, multiple dev environments, UAT, whatever, just write us an email at info@pdfbutler.com, and we will provide you those stages. Any input, any news that you want to mention to us, just let me know, and we'll put it into our next release. So that is already ongoing. This release is for this weekend, the 27th. So if you have any feedback, just let us know. Thanks.